Hello, my name is Phoebe Roberts, and I am the creator of the Mrs. Hawking Adventure Series. Heaven knows it has been a long, strange year for everyone, but particularly for performance artists who have to find some way to practice their craft under these very difficult circumstances. So I am incredibly proud to be part of a group of artists who put their heads together to figure out an entirely new way of doing theater, and who were willing to set up equipment in their own spaces to pre-record scratch tracks so they could perform their parts at different places at different times so that we could stitch it together into something that captures the magic that is Mrs. Hawking. And this one in particular is a special story because this is our Jack the Ripper story, which we have dreamed of tackling for years because it's a perfect fit for a character like Mrs. Hawking. But with our particular deconstructionist take, we wanted to take the focus off of the murderer and put it onto the women who were affected by his actions and sort of bring their humanity to the forefront in a way that is not often done, I think, in stories of this type. And to that end, we are going to be saying their names. We are going to be saying them over and over again in hopes that you will remember them and carry them forward. And with that, I would like to welcome you and thank you for your presence here at Mrs. Hawking Part 6, Fallen Women. I hope you enjoy the show.
Fancy meeting you here.
Have a look at that. Is this your harbour master's Missy Moneyfest? Nonagan stashed it in the tack house under a harness the mould had gotten to.
I knew you'd find it.
And have you done on me tip-off?
Already picked the bloke up. Once we showed him the murder weapon, he sang like a canary.
Oh, well done. Thanks for taking a moment to haul him in. I know you're mostly undercover these days.
It's no bother to make a collar. Honestly, I'm half expected to be called back to the beat any day now. It's all lands on deck with them. What's going on in Whitechapel?
The murders. Women sliced to bits.
With the last two both cut down in one night, things are reaching a panic. I've heard from the other couples, even the home office has stuck its oar in. Oh, folks have got a name for him now as well, from that barking letter sent into the newspapers.
I've heard it. Jack the Ripper.
I was surprised you never said nothing about it. Well, I know I'm not supposed to pry too much, but this seemed like it'd be right up your mistress's alley.
She's climbing the walls over it, but she can't investigate. Scotland Yard's all through it, and they're all on guard against her. Even now, whenever they see her costume, they charge her on sight.
Well, she has blacked out quite a few teeth at this point.
If the police handle it, so much the better. But I don't know how much longer we can stand by, with women's lives at stake.
Of course. So, this is it for you, then, is it? This work with Mrs. Hawking? Solving crimes and righting wrongs? This is what you were meant for?
I think it is. She means for me to take over for her someday. It's not always been easy, but it means the world to me.
I figured you'd say that. So I never made an arse of myself presuming any different, but I wanted to be sure, just in case.
Why?
Well, you know I've been working undercover these past few years. Must be doing well enough because I got an offer for a new job.
A promotion?
You could call it that, only it's not with the Yard, it's with the Foreign Office. They were looking for lads with intelligence experience, and I suppose in the last few years I caught their eye.
Oh, Arthur, congratulations.
Thank you. It's only... the post's abroad. In New York. America. It's a good post. And I get to see something of the world. I wanted to tell you, but I don't think I can take it.
Why ever not?
Well, because I know you can't leave. And I want to ask you to marry me. I've been thinking it for some time now. Sometimes I feel like such a cad for never making you any promises. You and me, Mary, we've had such fun as we are, chasing about after ruffians and picking mysteries apart. But I know how important your work is to you and the people you do it for. I know your life isn't one that lends itself to being somebody's missus at home. And damn if I'm going to be the man to get in the way of that. But God knows you know your own mind, and I'd never forgive myself if I didn't ask. Because I love you, Mary, as truly as ever a man loved a woman. And if you love me, there's nowhere else I'd like to be. For whatever that means, lead, and I'll follow. Hang it all, this was not how I meant to do this. I was going to have a ring and get down on one knee and all that rot.
Stand up, you silly git. Whatever would you do with a ring? Use it to pop a ruffian.
So, you don't mind?
Harvey, you don't know what it means to me. We made quite a team, haven't we? For every twist and turn, you've been everything I needed. You're right about my work, of course. I'm meant for it, and I can't see my life without it. I don't know how being a wife would fit in, but I can't see my life without you either.
As long as you love me, I'll never put you in a place where you must choose. We can continue on as we are, if that's all it can be.
I want to be with you, Arthur. It's just, I don't know how.
Nor I. Only I had to tell you, or else I might burst.
May I have some time?
Like I said, lead and I'll follow.
Again. Better, but vary your rhythm this time and release your shoulders. I said release your shoulders. Well, your form's improved, but you're telegraphing your blows.
I know.
You've got to practice.
I know. I have been.
After what happened to you when Frost caught you.
I haven't forgotten.
I can't allow you to be that vulnerable, not again. If you are going afield at all on cases, then you must be able to defend yourself.
And if I can't, what use am I?
I beg your pardon.
Nothing. It's only, if only I were clever enough to puzzle it all out from an armchair with a pound of shag tobacco.
Good heavens, you're not still on about that bloody book.
I thought it was cracking, and quite funny considering what we do.
Fantastical nonsense. Everybody knows enough to read everything all the time.
Still, I quite enjoyed it. Perhaps Mary and I should chronicle your cases for posterity.
You wouldn't dare. Perhaps you would. What would I know of it?
Please don't say that.
Then don't change the subject. Someday you will be in danger again, and there won't always be someone there to pull you out of it. Do you want to spend another week tied to a chair in some villain's cellar?
No! It's only, I'm struggling.
It's a struggle for anyone. But I need to know that you're safe.
I can shoot. A little. What? Now? In the house?
Go on. Sight along the barrel with both eyes open. Squeeze. Don't pull. And breathe out as you do. Not bad. You have the stance of a doula.
I got my basics in my year in the service, but that's a dozen years gone now, and I haven't had much practice since.
Then you'll practice now.
Only, I've never seen you use one.
Ugh, I never had a taste for guns. The smell, the noise, they're anathema to subtlety and stealth, and they smack of the male establishment. A blunt approach rather than a surgical one. But this is not a game, Nathaniel. There are no rules of fair play, and you cannot run these risks without protecting yourself.
Bullseye.
You do what you must. Remember what I said? It won't happen again.
Back, madam. Did I hear shots?
I was training, but now we can make report.
What become of the extortionists that Frost had in Cheapside?
Thanks to some well-placed letters, each of the ringleaders thinks the other has sold them out to the yard.
I expect, in turning their sights on each other, they'll soon have sunk their whole operation.
Which takes care of two more of Frost's lieutenants. And you, Mary, has the man you pegged for the gardener murder been taken in?
Just last night. I passed off the barley song knife and the blood-stained gloves to Arthur. When the coppers came, he cracked like an egg.
You handed over all of the evidence to the police?
Yes. To confront the killer, is there something else you'd have me do?
No. It sounds as if you've got it well in hand.
Well, that settles that, then. We should have time to take on something new.
Yes. More distractions from the only case that matters.
Madam, we've been over this. There are too many police about it to involve yourself in the Ripper case.
For all the good they've done, two more women are dead in a single night. How many more will there be while we stand by?
And how do you mean to investigate? You can't go out in your suit now that the coppers have come to recognize it.
Frost's works are not easily undone.
So you would have us do nothing?
There are people out there without an army of policemen to help them. Charging after the Ripper and your hood won't save this time.
Make no mistake, Miss Stone. If I have my way, my hood will be the last thing that monster ever sees. Now, if that's all, you must excuse me. I have an appointment.
I am sorry.
She doesn't trust a word I say anymore. It's my own fault. I should have known better than to lie to her for so long.
I did, right along with you. I mean, I suppose you decided after my drubbing I'd already paid enough.
Perhaps I ought to try it. Maybe then we'll get past this.
Unfortunately, on the whole, I can't recommend it.
How are you bearing up?
It isn't so bad. Sometimes my jaw still aches when I talk too much, which is all the time. Do wish I could get it out of my mind, though. I find myself remembering it still, and all at the worst times.
Oh, Nathaniel, I'm sorry.
Time will heal it, I'm sure. Just as it will for you and Madam.
I'm afraid I'm not so certain. You see, there's something else. I saw Arthur today.
Yes?
We talked of cases, his and mine, and he asked after me work, and if I intended to do it always, and I said yes, and he said he expected so.
Yes?
And he didn't know how we'd manage it, but he, well...
He asked you to marry him!
How did you know?
Because I've been after him for weeks! I tell you, left to his own devices, he would have done it over a dead body or during a street brawl. Oh, tell me, where did he do it? Kensington Gardens? The Abbey? And what about the ring? Did he write to ask for his mother's after all?
Nathaniel, none of that! There wasn't any ring!
Tell me you're joking. Has the lad lost his mind? When I proposed to Clara, I'd crossed the length of the country, had a new jacket made, and took her in a carriage onto a seaside picnic. And if I'd tried without a ring, the only hand I'd have had of hers was the back of it.
I haven't even answered him yet.
Why ever not? Is it because of the ring?
Of course not. It's only... I don't know how to do it. Be married with the life that I lead.
Oh, I see. But this is what you want, isn't it?
I think it is.
Mary... Then this is the very best news.
I don't think Mrs. Hawking will agree. Oh, but I've got to tell her. I can't keep any more secrets from her. Not when that started all this strife.
Oh, heavens. So much for the engagement party.
It won't make things any easier between us.
Not at first. But we'll manage her. You'll see. We'll bring her round. Now buck up, my girl. You're to be married. Might as well enjoy it a moment before Madam takes all the fun out of it.
Goodness, I am. It's all struck me of a sudden.
It's about damn time, if you ask me. I do love weddings. You will let Clara and I plan things, won't you?
One thing at a time. I must accept Arthur yet. You're not going to cry, are you?
I make no promises.
You're late.
I'm 10 minutes early.
You were due on the 3rd. You're 2 whole days late.
Well, if I'm imposing, I could always stop my visits. But then, I imagine your days would grow quite dull. Wouldn't they? Besides, couldn't be helped. I've been out working, no thanks to you.
Are the bobbies still hounding you after all this time? I'm not even paying them anymore. But I suppose you deck one copper and they're your enemy forever.
More than one at this point.
I'm sure. Especially with the hash they're making out of the Whitechapel murders. Looks like our fellow struck again. And twice this time.
Lives I might have saved if you hadn't put them on my trail. With the police swarming over the matter, I can't get near it.
Indeed. I can only imagine how that must feel. Still, I would not worry. According to these, there are several good suspects well in hand.
Sensationalist rubbish.
How would you know? I thought you could not get near enough.
The inquests are public. I've paid for copies of the reports.
And what have the rags gotten wrong?
Besides the speculation on the usual collection of scapegoats. Immigrants, madmen, Jews. Besides a half dozen witness descriptions and wild conflict. Besides the complete disregard for facts of any kind.
Oh, you mean to suggest those amusingly misspelled letters they print are not actually from the killer?
All of them mailed since reports reached the news.
A shame. I did so hope that dear boss had eaten someone's kidney. And now, there are two new victims, both killed within hours of one another. I suppose he did not have time to collect his usual remembrance from the first one.
He must have been interrupted because he works like lightning. The rest of them had been found before the bleeding had stopped, even after he took the time to open them up.
Yeah, it's clear he's a military surgeon, is he not?
What?
He went straight for the organs, did he not? I have known enough educated men without the faintest idea of a woman's anatomy. I doubt your average Whitechapel illiterate could locate a womb or kidney on the first try.
But the cuts are so coarse.
Battlefield training. They've got the basics, but not much is expected of them. And they're accustomed to working fast, or hadn't you already got that together?
What are you doing?
Why, discussing a matter of interest with a dear old friend.
Why?
What bloody else have I got to do in here?
I put you in here.
Yes, you did. But I know you mean to find this man and stop him by any means necessary. You know I live for the game. What are the chances of I to play it?
I should have nothing to do with you after what you did to my nephew.
And I should wish you dead after what you did to me. Now, dear boss, what else have you for me?
Four women, murdered over the course of 2 months by means of a sharp blade in the slums of Whitechapel. No stab wounds at all, only slashes. Most had organs removed in their entirety. Kidneys, liver, once even the womb, each one more brutalized than the last.
He's intensifying. He was interrupted in his third attempt and could not bear to go home without a souvenir. Where were the bodies found? Have you a map to mark them?
Pulley Nichols in Buck's Row. Must you do that? It's a small room.
Yes, it is. And you've only yourself to blame. Annie Chapman on Hanbury Street.
Well, I suppose you're not the first I've driven to vice.
Oh, indeed. I imagine the Colonel was a chimney by the end.
That was the least of it. Elizabeth Stride, Duffield's Yard.
What was his poison? Drink?
Most people didn't see it. Nathaniel certainly didn't. Catherine Eddowes, Mitre Square.
All within an hour's walk or so. All in alleyways or yards or someplace reasonably secluded. He knows the lay of the land. A local?
Then where does he go?
Perhaps he disappears into plain sight. Tell me, how fares Nathaniel these days? Our very own Ghost of Christmas Past. Oh, come now. A little conversation is a small price to pay.
Braver and stronger than ever you knew. But if our man does live there, how does he disappear so completely?
Perhaps?
I'd say he has somewhere else to go when the investigation gets underway.
Who comes to Whitechapel enough to know it, but does not have to live there? What military surgeon does?
A workhouse doctor! Well, their standards are low. They wouldn't need an accomplished medical man.
Often volunteers from the superior classes who mean to do a charitable deed. Volunteers who need not live in the same pit as their patience.
The houses on Charles Street and the South Grove are both within a mile.
It looks as if you have a place to begin.
Of course, the area is crawling with police officers. Thanks to you, I won't be able to investigate using my usual low profile.
I thought you were good at this. Whatever did you do before you could pass off the hard work to the boy and the girl? Go in plain clothes. They shan't be on the alert for that. What's the worst that could happen? You'll have to talk to someone. In the meanwhile, I shall think on what I will ask in exchange for the next consultation.
And who is to say there shall be a next consultation?
At any rate, we shall call this one gratis. Or nearly so. The next one, however, that will cost you.
No trouble. I just want to know about the Ripper.
No matter. It's not safe chasing into this girl.
It's not safe anyhow. Ain't like there's anywhere to hide.
So what do you think you're doing? What's your interest in the Ripper?
I'm trying to find him.
Find him? Why?
Because he's killing us. The coppers have done nothing. We can't wait any longer.
You have no idea what you've gotten yourself into. Stay off the streets, and you'll live through this.
And go where? Women are dying! Somebody's got to put a stop to it!
Someone is.
And what about you, then? Walking around bold as brass? Are you the one, then? I've heard of you. The Avenger they talk of. The one who looks out for women. I could help you.
I don't need help from the likes of you.
And what like is that? Poor girls or just whores? I don't care what you think of me. I know what they say about you. I'm on your side. If everything they say is true.
And what do they say?
That you make men afraid.
Who are you? Where did you come from?
Limerick and some Cardiff.
You don't sound it.
I went to school some. We weren't all of us always trash. But my husband died down the mine and my family sent me away.
For being widowed? Not likely. What really happened?
There weren't no husband. But I had a baby, see? And no one in the village would have anything to do with me. So the nuns took him and I was on my own.
And there was nothing else for you.
Some of us ain't lucky. Don't mean we deserve to die. More than that, ma'am. I found something. Something no one else has. A woman who knew them. All four of them.
All four of the victims? No one knew all of them. There's been no connection between them.
Nothing the coppers could find. But I did. I know the streets around here. Do you?
Who is this person?
If I tell you, will you let me help?
Darling, what's this?
Chapman was brushing out your overcoat and found your wallet in the pocket. I thought I'd bring it by.
Oh, thank you, although I'm sure Chapman himself could have very easily done that.
He also found this. And the sideboard dry. And two more hidden among your things.
It's getting worse, isn't it? Is that why you've been sleeping in the dressing room?
Not sleeping, more like. The nightmares still.
About Mrs. Frost.
About what happened. The things she said to me.
Darling, I'm sorry. But she's finished, Nathaniel, and she's a liar.
Not in everything. And I can't seem to get it out of my head.
What's to be done?
I don't know, but... I'm not well, love.
Is this a serious case you're working? You're after a madman. If you're not well...
This is important, Clara. Women's lives are at stake. And Madam and Mary need me. I cannot let them down.
Then... we'll manage it somehow. We'll come through this.
How?
Together.
They'll be here any moment. Clara, what brings you here?
Oh, I just wanted to remind you that we'll be interviewing governesses for Beatrice soon. I'm open to advice, if you speak gently.
God is my witness. I will see that she at least studies logic and history along with etiquette and conversational French. But you'd best be on your way now, unless you're keen to sit in on an interview with a rather different sort of woman.
The fallen kind.
My goodness. I'll leave that part out when I talk to the governesses.
I wanted to ask, how did you come to find this Mary Jane Kelly? It isn't as though she's mentioned in the inquest.
I made a consultation. The idea of workhouse infirmaries arose.
You consulted with someone? Who?
Elizabeth Frost.
I beg your pardon?
This is an opaque problem with lives at stake. The circumstances demanded it.
You still see her? You still go to see her? Why?
To keep eyes on her.
Because she's so dangerous.
They can't take that away from her, even in there.
You know what she did to me.
I know.
Then how can you trust her?
I don't. But we're at a severe disadvantage in investigating this. More lives may be lost if we cannot track this killer down.
But she's a monster.
And that's why I can't let her out of my sight.
Still, after all she put Nathaniel through.
No. The circumstances are dire. We must use every advantage we have.
Good afternoon, Miss Kelly. Thank you for coming. These are my assistants, my maid, Miss Stone, and my nephew, Mr. Hawking.
You're right then, sir.
Oh, I'm sorry. It's only I've never met one before. One of you before. Oh, not that it isn't a pleasure to make your acquaintance the way it would any lady. It's just, I've never had occasion. I'm a married man. Oh, dear God.
Pleased to meet you too, sir.
Blimey, fancy place you've got here.
I take it you are Miss Violet Strollin?
Yes, ma'am. And I'd be obliged if we could get on with things. I have to be back across town for work.
We'll get to it then. So, you knew all four victims?
Knew might be a bit strong, but I met them. Over the course of my work, I ran into them here and there.
Are you in the same profession as Miss Kelly and the others?
I'm a nurse. I used to have a place with a doctor in town. But now it's the infirmaries for folks about in the neighbourhood.
Do you think we're all streetwalkers then? Polly and Annie weren't neither.
They weren't.
How can you be so sure?
Because folks would have said. I told you, I've been asking around. Nobody said it except newspaper men who make up whatever they please.
And what difference if they were?
Indeed. And when you say the infirmaries, you mean those of the workhouses?
Yes, ma'am. That's where I met them. They'd come to stay and came in taken ill.
Do you recall when?
What, each one? Can't rightly say, but all of them in the last year or so.
And when you saw them, was there anyone else who was also about at all the same times? A particular doctor, perhaps?
I don't remember.
Think on it. Who might have been in the same place to encounter them when you did?
I don't know, all right. It weren't always the same workhouse, see?
You went between them. More than once. Why?
My choice. Handed me my papers.
Why? We've no time for games, Miss Strawler.
Might as well tell, Violet.
Of a taste for drink. They catch me at the cabinet one time too many, and they toss me out for a few months. I go between the two.
I see.
Here now, what's it matter?
When you said you had a witness, I'd hoped she'd remembered something of use.
Madam, perhaps be kind?
Or didn't know it was something worth recalling.
But a madman may have walked in your midst. A madman may still.
Do you want more women to end up like the others? I thought you were supposed to be on our side.
Well, what's that they say of you? You old folks who ain't got nobody else. Well, let me tell you, there's nobody more friendless than us.
Of course. It's only that we must find this man to do it. And what you remember may be the only way.
Well, the first one, Polly, came in for gout in the knee. I'd say about late February. The second one had that sore on her back, and he shared whiskey she nicked with me. Oh, it was one name. It was so odd, I couldn't help making out. The times I met him, folks would come by the wards asking for one doctor by name, Dr. Seven.
And who is that? Do you know him?
Oh, far as I could tell, there was no doctor by name of Seven. Still, folks would come asking, saying they had money to tell him they came by.
Can't be a mistake if so many people came asking.
Are you certain, Miss Strollen? You cannot think of anyone else who was also there at all the same times that the women
She's
were.
She's already told you, for heaven's sake! Must you keep bullying?
No. We've got something to go on now. We'll proceed with that.
In the meantime, you might do well to stay off the streets of Whitechapel as much as you can. Perhaps the workhouses, too.
It's our own. Where else can we go?
I won't just hide while that monster's still out there.
You've handled this very bravely, Miss Kelly, but you must put the matter into our hands. We'll find justice for them. We promise.
Nathaniel, hail a cab for Mrs. Kelly and Strollen. See that they're taken wherever they wish to go.
Yes, ma'am.
They had names, you know. Polly Nichols. Annie Chapman. Elizabeth Stride. Catherine Eddowes. Don't forget.
We'll look into this, Dr. Savin, see if he goes by any other names.
Perhaps there are records to be had of people in a similar place to Violet in the workhouses. You never told us you visited Frost.
I didn't want to trouble you.
I believe you never wanted trouble, though perhaps not the way you mean. Is this what we do now? We wig around one another so it's less trouble for the both of us.
I don't know. What was your reasoning for when you kept your cases and your policemen behind my back?
I suppose there was something of that. But that's not how I want it to be. I made a promise that I wouldn't keep secrets just because I was afraid of what you'd think. Arthur's asked me to marry him. I haven't given him an answer yet, but I don't know how it fit into things, but I mean to consider it, and I wanted you to know.
I knew that one day you would leave for that man.
Leaving? I haven't even accepted him.
But you will, and that will be the end of it. Put finish to this betrayal of years by inches.
When you said you understood I'd be having my own life, what did that mean? As long as nothing ever changed. As long as you approved of whatever it was I chose.
I wonder what choice you'll have. How precisely do you plan to carry out missions and conduct investigations with your husband expecting you at home?
And who is it that'll make me choose?
The circumstances, as they do for us all.
Nathaniel gets his life. He's got his work and his family, and you don't begrudge him that.
I'm just grateful he has something to take him away every once in a while.
But it doesn't stop him being of use. Do you expect any less of me?
On the contrary, you could become things Nathaniel never could.
And what is that? You?
Better than me! You could carry out real change in the world. Not just a few rescued souls here and there. A true challenge to everything that makes them so vulnerable. You could be more than I ever could.
If that's so, why can't I do it my own way?
Because marriage will take that all from you. I would move heaven and earth to spare you that.
I know what your marriage was like. what your husband was like. But that's no tie that you don't know him.
I know men. There is no free pursuit of our work amongst them, and there'd be no need for it without them. And I don't want to lose you.
Yes, you say I can do better, be better. You don't believe that.
I believe that more than anything.
No, because that would mean you believe that things could change and that you cannot imagine. Not even for me. No matter how I love you, even as you make it so hard. So I pray to God, madam, it is true that I need never, ever be like you. I'll be after those records then, as women are counting on us.
Well, it's a solid lead if the information's reliable. Shame you could not dig up a better class of witness.
Trunks and streetwalkers are vulnerable. That's why he chooses them.
So, what do you make of this mysterious Dr. Savin?
I expect it's a pseudonym. Someone running a side venture under cover of the workhouse infirmaries.
And you think that's your man? Must be busy, ministering to unfortunates during the day while butchering them at night.
Well, whoever it is, it seems he had the same exposure to the four victims that the nurse did, and that's the only lead we have so far.
How lovely it must be to have a real problem again. After me, I can only imagine how dull your cases must seem by comparison.
Four murders is too interesting even for me.
Only because they still confound you. And Alexander wept that among infinite worlds, he was not yet master of one.
Your empire crumbled much the same as his did. Without you, none of your remaining lieutenants could hold it.
And I'm sure you had your fun hastening it along. Do you know how long I worked to build it all? Have you any idea what I had to do?
I know what it takes to break out of one's cage.
Indeed. So, dear boss, what is your next move? How shall you be hunting down this so-called Dr. Savin?
Well, Mary's looking into records of those who served in the workhouses in a medical capacity at the same times as Miss Strollen did.
Why don't you tell me about this girl of yours, Miss Mary Stone?
Why? So you can lock her in a room and torment her too?
No, I leave that to you these days. But it is a rare maid that means so much to a solitary goblin like you. Your nephew's history I read like a newspaper, but that girl's name was hardly known in her own church. I told you, only the first time was free.
She's Phyllis. She came to me knowing nothing, or near to it. Having seen nothing of the world, nor knowing any advantage of it, she offered herself up to learn everything, anything that it would take to take on its darkness. Fearless to learn, fearless to fail, fearless of everything. Even of me. I always thought I was the limit of what challenge could be made. But she made me hopeful. For the first time in 20 years, I had hope. She could be everything, if she chooses to be.
Fascinating. I cannot say I ever thought that for my own daughter. What? Does it surprise you to hear about my girl?
You mean Miranda, nay Cameron, now Mrs. Michael Barrymore of Hong Kong. You're not the only one who does research.
Fair enough. I suppose we were never so close. Honestly, I meant to avoid the whole business, but it caught us by surprise in 64. Same year as yours, I believe. Though to somewhat more permanent effect. I did my best for her, but I suppose I was like you in that regard. Cut out for the softer parts of motherhood.
Does she even know what's become of you? I noticed there have been no letters.
As I said, I brought her up right. Governesses, boarding school. A respectable marriage. Enough that she has no need of me anymore. But I suppose it's for the best. There are costs to living as you and I have. Why drag them down with us? What if Mary finds no name that matches the times of Miss Strowland's employment? The records in those places are hardly precise.
Well, then I suppose I'll have to track him by his false name, see what people want with Dr. Savin.
Have a moment. What does Savin mean?
Oh, it's a type of juniper, but it has no medical use. It's poison. Could they mean to hire a poisoner, do you think?
Yes, but not in the way you think.
What? What is it?
He's an abortionist. He's an abortionist! Think on it. He is a physician, but this he must practice in secret and under a false name. And then poor and desperate women put themselves in his hands, who no one would miss if they disappeared.
But those women were not with child.
Not those women. But I wager this is how he began. Girls who died on the table. Girls who died for their own mistake. And no one dare give him away, lest anyone discover what they wanted of him.
But now, helpless or so unconscious girls aren't enough. Now to capture the thrill again, he has to hunt them. Polly Nichols, Annie Chapman, Elizabeth Stride, and Catherine Eddowes.
And now, you may hunt him. You're welcome.
What's this?
Apologies. I'm out of sorts. That and I gave my cobalt to a prostitute out of pity yesterday, so I'm not exactly—
Put it down. On your feet.
You cut me. Please, I'm not dressed to
prepare— Do you think that will matter in the thick of it? On your feet, Hawking.
I don't think you mean to practice.
There, you're dead.
I won't do this.
There, you're dead again. Come on, defend yourself.
Auntie.
Come on.
Madam.
Come on.
Do you think I won't take a beating for you? Haven't I proved that once enough? I know you're still not well. I know how hard this has been.
I thought that when we put paint to frost, that would quiet it. It hasn't.
I understand. Better than you may think.
I used to be so certain of myself, of my plans, my capabilities. I operated alone for nearly 20 years. Blasted, but now, perhaps because I'm getting older, perhaps I'm too accustomed to having help, but now everything seems so much greater than me.
You used to be alone, but you're not anymore. We're a team. We're supposed to rely on each other.
Of course, of course.
Why must you keep talking like that? We've done nothing but work to help you for the past 8 years.
Oh, indeed. And is that what you call lying to me for the last year and a half?
We've apologized 100 times for that mistake. One we made for love of you. Has it really destroyed all the trust you had in us? Is that why you turn instead to Mrs. Frost?
You don't understand.
Then explain it to me. Why do you need her so, to solve this case?
She's brilliant. More than we are, any of us.
We can manage it, the three of us, like we always do.
This is different.
How?
Because I feel a ruin, Nathaniel, and it isn't getting any better. Because the police have stopped me from operating, and because I'm getting older every day. And because I rely upon a support driven to drink. What is there that fixes all that?
Whatever it is, you won't find it in Elizabeth Frost. I want you to stop going to her. For my sake, if not yours.
Nathaniel...
I know what she means to you. I know that isn't easily erased.
It isn't about that.
And I know the guilt you bear in locking her away.
Can you blame me?
No. It was a terrible thing, but you had no choice. You did it to save me and all the others she stood to hurt. But Elizabeth Frost is poison. I know what it is to listen to her. I may never shake her voice from inside my head. And we both know that she knows where you are weak.
So what am I to do?
Let us be there to help carry the burden. Stop trying to push us away.
For Christ's sake!
No! That's what people do. It's how they survive. I must believe that. I'll spend the rest of my life tied to a chair in Elizabeth Frost's lair whenever I close my eyes.
You are stronger than for one beating to break you.
It wasn't just the beating. She said things. Things I'd do anything to forget about me, my life. You and Uncle.
What do you mean?
You need never again doubt. I know why it is so hard for you to look at me. If I've suffered for you, so have you for me. We ought to do what we can for each other so we can move past this. I want us to heal. I want you to teach my son and inspire my daughter. I won't give up on that. Won't you do the same?
Oh, of course. God forbid for a moment you're out of good graces.
Oh, it isn't about that anymore. Can we never move forward? How can... There. There, that's it.
What are you doing?
Putting the past to rest. It's long past time.
Why?
Because I have hope for both of us to get better.
What would you do with it?
I'll take him home with me. Hang him in the study or the hall, someplace of respect. He deserves that much, but he doesn't need to be there, hanging over you all the time.
Your father will give you hell. Thank you.
I should have done it years ago, but I mean to look forward now.
Arthur, what are you doing here?
The girl from Whitechapel, the one you found. Was her name Mary Jane Kelly? Did she live at Miller's Cove?
Why?
Dear Christ. Because she's dead.
What?
Murdered in her bed. More than murdered. I was on the scene myself a few hours ago. Never saw anything like it in my life.
What? How do you mean?
Don't you see? He found her. The Ripper. He found her. He did her like the others.
Good God.
No, it were worse than the others. Madness. From a bloody nightmare. Her landlord found her in her room at Miller's Court. I went into that room, sir. I saw her. It were... I weren't ready. Not for that.
That can't have been an accident. He had to have known.
Which means he knows we're on his trail.
How could he ever find that out? Just because she was asking after the case?
I don't know. But she don't fit the pattern. She was alone in her house. He had to have known to go after her. I never saw even an animal butchered like that. Dressed out like a deer, but not cleaned up neat. There were pieces of her all over that room. On the mantelpiece, in the hearth, everywhere. It were...
Oh, Arthur, we can still find him. It's not too late.
It is for Miss Kelly. We failed her.
If he knew about Mary Jane, he may be after Violet, too.
He could already have found her for all we know. All while the assistant commissioner shuffles papers back and forth to the Home Office.
The Home Office? What have they got to do with this?
Commissioner Warren has been battling the Home Secretary since the very beginning. The assistant commissioner is his man, you know. Secretary Matthews put Robert Anderson in charge of the case. First he buggers off to Switzerland for a month, now he drowns us in red tape.
Do you mean to say that the Home Secretary is interfering in the investigation?
Since the bloody beginning. Commissioner Warren up and resigned last night thanks to all the badgering.
What could the Home Office possibly... Melissa means to hinder them. Or protect him.
What? Why would it do such a thing?
I don't know, but it can't stand. You, now. Sergeant Swan. You're on the case now, are you? Then you can get close. You've got to implicate this Robert Anderson in something. Women embezzling some scandal. Get him tossed off his post.
Are you joking?
Do you imagine that for a moment?
Here now, madam. I never told nobody about Miss Strallen because you asked me to. Nor about you, for that matter. But it's quite another thing to make up false evidence against an innocent man.
Oh, hardly innocent if he's a tool of such a scheme. Besides, policemen do it every day for less than this.
To what end? Won't they just put another of their men in his place?
I mean to help you, madam, but I took an oath.
As if that meant anything to the likes of you.
You would not need my help if your brothers and aunts were capable, and I would not need yours if they were not corrupt.
Well, then one of us ought to do better, don't you think? I want this monster caught as bad as you do, but I won't do that.
Then stand aside.
You're of no use to anybody.
Well, hey now, there's no need for that. Arthur's doing what he can.
Of course. I suppose you would know.
There's no time for this. We've got to find Violet before that madman does.
How? She doesn't even have a permanent address.
That may be a blessing in disguise. If we have to search for her, so does he.
The badge will let me look in at the workhouses.
Good. The infirmaries and the wards as well. And the lodging house and the public houses and not to mention the streets in between.
Do you mean we have to comb through all of Whitechapel?
There's not a moment to lose.
Yes, he can. Hail a cab and take the sergeant. I'm counting on you.
Come on. We'll go it together.
Just a moment. Find a boy and pay him to go to this address with a message from Mrs. Johanna Brown.
Johanna Brown? In the German embassy case? What for?
Tell her I'm calling in my marker. I want to speak to her mother. Madam?
Still insisting on this stealth nonsense, I see. Take off that ridiculous hood. We know who you are. If nothing else, you'll stand before us uncovered. You're fortunate we even deign to see you, with all your conditions and terms.
You can't afford to make an enemy me.
Is you will not let us forget. But enough of this. What do you want?
I want his name. You know who I mean. This has gone too far.
Why, would you believe we even possess that information?
Because you bar my way after him. Having the Home Office install a puppet in the investigation to drown the case in bureaucracy and keep the police off his trail. This man must have very high friends indeed. You must know something.
It is not so simple.
What then? Of course. You've made use of him, haven't you? What, your blasted grandson getting upset on Catholic shopgirls again?
Have a care of what you suggest, madam.
You permit a butcher of women to roam free in your own city!
There is more at stake here than a few lost souls.
There is nothing more at stake than this!
Is that what you believe? Before you were even born, I came into a burden the weight of half the world. For 50 years I have held it, against the constant bettering of time and tide. You cannot imagine what it calls for, to keep the balance, to bring order, progress, stability out of the chaos. You rage against it in your heedless fury. Who would you be if you were not a daughter of my empire? The Colonel never knew about any of this, did he? Well, I suppose he had secrets enough of his own.
What do you mean?
Oh, if he never saw fit to tell you, I am not about to. Suffice to say, he understood that which you do not.
My life's work would be to burn down everything that you have built.
You will not be the first to try. Now, this has gone far enough. What are your terms?
First, stand down your men. Do what you like with the police, but you will not shield him from me.
Well, he's no longer of any use like this. But it cannot come out. None of this affair, nor anything that he knows. And what else?
I want his name.
Whatever you do, we can either help nor protect you.
I've always done without that.
Must end it. He disappears. Without a witness, without a word.
On that, we are agreed. Now, Matt. His name! You were right in most of it. Former military surgeon, returning home from the balls to build quite the place for himself, quietly relieving society families of unwanted heirs, all the while volunteering his ministries to the unfortunates of the workhouses as an act of Christian charity. I ought to cut him down on the carpet in his office on Harley Street.
How quiet is it when such a man is found murdered in his bed? He will have to be in whatever lair he keeps for cutting up gravid women in Whitechapel.
I already sent Clara to look into Harley Street physicians doing charity work, but we've no time to waste waiting.
Ah, yes, your charming, well-connected niece-in-law. No matter, we shall do it the old-fashioned way. Eliminating the very public establishments, the ones explored by the police, and all the partition residential flats. Even in Whitechapel, it is not the sort of work that can bear the scrutiny of the neighbours.
I imagine there were quite a few bodies to spirit out of the place when he first started indulging his impulses.
Which narrows his prospects considerably, to our advantage. Therefore, given the spread of proximity and the path from the Edo scene to the bloody scrap of her apron found on Goulston Street... There.
How can you be so sure?
Close enough. You may have to do a little bit of reconnaissance, but you're good at that, dear boss. And you will be in uniform again. It has been some time, has it not? Since you could solve a problem the straightforward way. Not since the children came into things, I imagine.
Not everyone has the stomach for it.
What is your approach?
Attack from behind, control the back. Get the neck in a hold and bring the blade in to end it. With speed, it'll be over in a blow or two.
What if you cannot get behind him?
Go for the hands. Cripple him first, or at least knock out the knife. Worst case, bone shield to ward him until I'm close enough to disarm.
And you are certain he cannot fight like you?
What are the chances? He cuts up street women. He's a butcher, not a warrior.
Most likely. But he will be bigger than you. Taller. Longer reach. And most certainly he will be younger. I cannot believe you still do this sort of thing yourself. How old are you now? 48? And you were still racing along rooftops and hurling yourself at grown men. Good God, I can feel my bones crumbling to dust just thinking about
it. I manage.
But for how much longer? Do you really think you can keep this up when you are 50 years old?
Is that what you think?
Yes, because you are a woman, Victoria. Because you have a gaping wound in you and they can smell it. You cannot afford not to think of it. If he gets a hold of you, you're finished.
I have to be fast. Hit and run if I have to.
I do. But then he will know you're coming.
There will be something. You can strategize all you like, but you can't know until you're in it. I'll find something. If I could not, I would not have made it to this age.
I suppose that is true. But you were always very sure of yourself. After all, you had no fear to biff a hero soldier twice your size the moment you laid eyes on him. Tell me, was that the last time that you took a swing at Reginald? Oh, it was not, was it? Fiery young fool you were. But surely he never struck back. Heavens, do you know how lucky you were? If he'd wanted to, what do you think he could have done? Of course, he never knew how dangerous you really were. It is a wonder you keep from cuffing that nephew of yours anytime you lay eyes on him.
He's a different man than his uncle was. He's forthright and hopeful. Always says exactly what's on his mind. Not at all the same, except now and again he'll tip his head to ask a question or drop his chin to laugh, and it will be like seeing that blasted ghost.
I am curious. Do you think you could have beaten him? Did you ever wonder over the years? Of course he did. Oh, I know you so well. He was not just a soldier. He was a warrior too. Of course you wondered.
I didn't wonder. I knew. I was in continual practice. He went soft in his old age.
could have beaten him, I know I could have.
And when he was a fit young hero? Instead of a broken, middle-aged wretch?
Even then, I told you, I remade myself. I worked, and I practiced, and I struggled every spare moment because... Because if I had not, any man with no more than God gave him could wreck me. Reginald fought with sabers and rode Gymkhana. He was a warrior. Blast him, but he was a man, so he didn't have to be. I did.
Were you hoping he would fight you? Were you looking for the chance?
What good would that do me? Would have revealed everything. Only a fool would have wanted that.
Nothing you ever wanted was good for you. But it was foolish. And not just for that. As if he'd ever raise a hand to you. He loved you, fool devil. And he was not that sort of a man.
No. But he thought I'd break into pieces. I wish just once he knew. Wouldn't be me to break.
My dear boss, you are a twisted creature. Are you not?
You would know.
Better than anyone. Good hunting, darling.
Oh, Miss Rollin! Miss Rollin! Oh, thank God, we've been after you for days.
Mr. Hawking? No, no, you can't be here. He's coming after me. He'll find me.
Please, you must come with me.
Do you see? He knows you're after him. You'll lead him right to me.
It's all right, we will protect you.
Like you did Mary Jane.
Mary Jane is the reason we're here. Please try to pull yourself together, woman.
Don't you judge me. You don't know how it is.
No. I don't. But I promise you, I don't judge.
Mary Jane was the strong one. So much stronger than me. If she couldn't escape him, what chance do I have?
You must be the strong one now. For Mary Jane and the others. And you needn't do it alone. Now, please, we must go!
Jesus Christ!
Thank God we came in time. Nathaniel, are you all right?
He came for Miss Stralin. Is she?
Well, she's not hurt. But who?
Bloody hell, Joe Quinn.
You.
Roland Davies.
Oh, not you lot again. Hasn't your boy Smug had enough of me?
You're Elizabeth Frost's henchman. What's got you after this woman?
I thought you lot were supposed to be clever. What do you think?
Mrs. Frost sent you.
I know where my bread's buttered. I was her man all the years she held this city under her thumb.
But why go after Violet? Why arrange for you to help this monster? What's gone on here?
You think four white walls is enough to stop the Kingmaker?
There you are, thank God.
Clara? What are you doing here? You know it isn't safe.
I know, but I had to find you. My God, who is...
Oh, never mind him. What is it?
You must tell me. Is Aunt Victoria with you? Did she ever come to meet you?
No. No, come to think of it, she never did. Why?
I went by the house. I had finished the research into the Harley Street doctors volunteering their time in Whitechapel. No one was home, so I let myself in. I went to take the intelligence up to her study and the cupboard was empty. Her suit is gone.
She's wearing the suit again? But the police are everywhere. Why on earth would she take the risk?
You told me what she said. That hood would be the last thing that man would ever see. She's found the Ripper, and she means to kill him.
You mean, would she do such a thing?
She would have killed Frost. There isn't any doubt in my mind.
But how could she even know where to find him? We don't even know his name.
I think she does.
How? Without telling anyone?
Well, that's the trouble. She did tell someone. Arthur, can you see that Mr. Davies has taken him to the yard and has got Miss Strallen safe back to the house?
Well, I can, Mary, but what are you going to do? How are you going to find her?
I don't know yet. Don't know how to find out.
Why, Mr. and Mrs. Hawking. Good evening. Nathaniel, my boy, you're looking well since last I saw you. And how is your lovely wife? May she burn in hell.
Spare us, Frost.
I must admit, madam, I've taken your name in vain more than once since my arrival here.
I don't think of you at all.
And yet, you're here. Both of you. And the girl, my dear, you must be Mary. I've heard so much about you.
What have you done?
Whatever do you mean?
Where is she?
Why, did she not tell you? Why ever would she do that?
No games, Frost.
We know she ran off on something you told her. What was it?
Only exactly what she asked.
For God's sake, woman, enough! Tell us what you did!
Just as I said. I gave her everything she needed. I helped her find him. I helped her devise her plan. Remember that I ran the demi-monde of this city for years. Of course I know how it operates. I knew a man the moment I saw the advertisement in the paper, using the codes such men do. I could not help coming to it ages before she did.
So she's gone after him, alone.
Is that not always her way? Just stalk off and sharpen her knives without a word to anyone else. Of course she's gone to hunt him down. Only this time, it is her walking into the trap.
What trap? My God, you warned him.
Oh, I may have sent an illuminating letter. Or two.
You don't mean... that monster knows she's coming.
Do you know how easy it was to drive her straight into the Ripper's lair? As if I did not know every rotted out hole and dark place in her.
You sent her to be butchered.
She destroyed everything I built. And then put me in a white room with no windows. I hope she dies, sobbing.
You're a monster.
I am Kingmaker.
If anything has happened to her, anything at all, I swear...
What will you do? Lock me away in a room for the rest of my life?
We should have let her kill you when she had the chance.
Yes. You should have.
That's why she sent Roland after Violet. She was trying to clear the Ripper's way so we could lie in wait for Madam.
I will murder her, I swear.
Forget her. She's nothing anymore. We have to find Mrs. Hawking. Stop her before she stumbles into his trap.
How? We don't even know his name.
She knows, God blast her, and where he must be hiding if she sent Madam there. But we won't have it out of her, that spiteful hag.
And what can we do? How can we find her?
Something she said. Something about seeing his advertisements. Knowing the code. What did that mean? What would he advertise?
The abortions. He advertised the abortions. He couldn't get the word out any other way. She knew it was him when she saw them.
That's it. They've been communicating through the newspapers, taking out advertisements written in code back and forth until she learned where to send a letter and where to send Mrs. Hawking.
Madam brought her the Times every visit.
There's not a moment to lose. We've got to go through those papers.
Good evening, Mrs. Hawking. I must say, I was quite thrown when the letters came. I thought I'd been caught and that was the end of me. Imagine my surprise. It was meant not to stop me, but to warn me. And even then, of a society widow, notoriously reclusive, and quite the old woman besides. I almost couldn't believe it. But then I've heard a word from Kingmakers not to be ignored.
Polly Nichols.
He told me not to underestimate you. But I must say I'm not impressed. Not if this is what passes for dangerous in a woman. Make no mistake, I've opened up far too many by now for that to hold any fascination. Or fear.
Any Chapman.
I fell into it in South Africa. On the Boer campaign. As it happens, there's quite the demand amongst the officers for the sawbones to see their pie blows away. And all for what? To be crushed into a few folds of skin. I saw men roiling with disease, ruining their lives and their careers for it. What was it that held such sway over the lives of men?
Elizabeth Strong.
And let me tell you, I have investigated. It's not hard to make a few gravid street whores disappear into the operating theater. Certainly no one misses them once their purpose has been served. And you'd be surprised at how few cuts it takes to reveal them for what they truly are. Scraps of meat that draw nothing, catch nothing, and make nothing. Now tell me, did you think you'd be any different?
Catherine Eddowes.
I will cut you apart as I have all the others. And when I do, when I lay you open, what will I find? It will be your soft women's guts. A bleeding sack of a womb withered from disuse. Made of the same meat, and every bit as soft. Did you think you were different? Did you think you were dangerous? Who did you think you are? Who are you?
Polly Nichols, Annie Chapman, Elizabeth Stride, Catherine Eddowes. Mary Jane Kelly.
Well, I will not waste any time saying I told you so. It isn't as if you ever listened to me anyhow.
You always think you know better. But if you did, you would not have ended up here. Of course, you always did love learning the hard way. Well, girl?
Stop straight.
It hurts.
Seen and not heard. You're a very fortunate girl. Not to count yourself that way.
Never again.
Ride the current, or drown in it.
That's just the way the world works.
Then blast the world!
Oh, that's right. You make your own way.
But you're not alone anymore.
Will you ever trust me?
Don't touch me!
Victoria! It's me.
Who?
My God, Victoria. Don't you know?
As if you haven't always been lucky.
Governor's girl.
Hero's wife.
Daughter of Empire.
Burn it! Burn it all to ash!
You would not be the first to try.
Beating against the bars of your cage.
Better than you have tried.
Haven't you done enough?
It's finished.
Finished before 50. Even he made 51.
Do you think I'm afraid?
I finished it!
What's that they say?
You make men afraid.
My funny old aunt.
Remarkable.
You fierce, fierce girl.
There's a cost to living the way you do. Who do you think you are?
Polly Nichols, Annie Chapman, Elizabeth Stride, Catherine Eddowes, Mary Jane Kelly.
Victoria Hawking.
Here lies Mrs. Colonel Reginald Prescott Hawking.
We had to be certain they saw you.
Beloved mother.
No mother.
Saw you for what you are.
It hurts! It hurts!
Beloved wife.
No wife.
Get it out of me! Get it out!
The pulse in my veins.
Put your hands up! God blast you, fight back! Do you think I'm afraid?
But is it enough?
Perhaps once.
Not anymore.
I finished it.
But how?
The Nighthawk.
I am your creature.
We had to be certain they saw you.
What have you done?
Do you think I'm afraid?
I saw you for what you are.
The lightning quick shadow in the mask.
Because I'll do anything. If you ask it, I'll do anything.
You're ridiculous, Hood.
What have you done? Do you think I'm afraid? Not of this.
The world offers so little recourse to women when its pressures become too great. Someone must step outside all that to do what is necessary.
Learning the hard way, then. Fancy that.
It is time, Missy Baba.
Like? Let's explore the cellar. Or go down to the pond and catch frogs.
It is getting dark out, and there is still so much to do.
I can't go on the roof anymore. That's ruined.
We are not the girls we used to be. Too much has happened for us to ever go back.
I can't bear it. Not again.
It's too late for that.
I should have done better. I should have known.
Now you have work to do.
What can I do?
Whatever you can. Whatever you have to. The way we always do.
This wasn't what I wanted. I never needed this. I never meant for this to happen. I don't think I can bear it.
Perhaps it is too late for you, but it is not too late for everyone.
Please, don't go.
Victoria, I've been gone a very long time.
But this is it. Hope we're not too late.
Oh my God. What happened here?
Don't touch anything. Don't touch anything.
Is that... Oh my God. She got him. She got him! But where is...
There.
Christ on the cross. Is she...
No. But she's badly hit. We must get her out of here. She needs help.
I'll bring her. Get a cab. Quickly. I'm here. Everything is going to be all right.
Don't touch me.
Please, you must keep still.
Get your hands off me.
Oh, God. Aunt Victoria, it's Nathaniel. It's me.
Nathaniel?
I've got a cab. This way.
We've done what we can. We've had to leave the bullet, but the wounds are clean and Violet stitched her up.
Best as I could do, anyway. She's lucky it didn't open her gut, but she's still fairly ripped and she's lost a gout of blood.
But will she be all right?
Hard to say, sir. Still decent odds she'll go septic and she'll not come to. Nothing to do now but wait for her to wake.
Thank you, Miss Strallen. We can't take her to hospital. I don't know what we'd have done without you.
There was the least I could do. After what she went through for me. For all of us.
Please don't tell anyone what's happened here. Not even that the Ripper is dead. Mrs. Hawking's life could depend on it.
You can count on me. God bless her. And you.
Take care of yourself, Violet. Please.
Perhaps we ought to go home too. Who knows how long it'll be before she wakes.
I couldn't. I want to be here when she does. I suppose that's always my trouble. I always want to be here. Even when there's nothing I can do.
We've got her this far. The rest she'll have to do on her own.
Of course. But she's strong. My God, she's strong as an ox to beat the bastard with a wound like that. Can you believe it?
Nothing about this surprises me. She would have done it to Frost to save you. Perhaps we should have let her. But I don't think I could bear for it to always be this way.
I don't see how else we could have ended this. But I don't think I could bear it either. The costs are all too high. She was never like anyone else I ever knew. Even when I was a little boy, she didn't act, talk, or even move like anyone else. The way she stalked like a panther, or else glided on ballet steps. even when I knew nothing else about her. That I could always see. She was expecting when I met her. Don't know why I thought of that. I was 8 or 9, I think. Yes, Uncle had just returned from abroad, and he brought her home to meet the family and have the baby. How strange to think of her that way now. Oh God, Mary, what if the worst should happen?
Don't think about that now.
I can't stop thinking of it.
She'll be all right. She must be. The last time I spoke to her, she was so angry, so hurt. Said Doctor betray her all at a shot instead of over the years by inches. Truly, she was horrid.
Oh, Mary.
And I told her how hard she made it to love her. And how I couldn't bear the thought of one day becoming like her. I said it because I was angry. Because it was true. She's been everything to me. How can we do this to one another? It can't be the last thing we ever say.
Madam! Oh, thank God!
You ought to be in bed. You must have rest.
Madam? Are you...
Are you still here?
I beg your pardon?
I'd have thought you'd have gone off with your Ismen by now.
Madam, I was frightened for you. I thought you might never wake. I wanted to be here.
Madam, what's come over you?
How can you be so cold?
Cold as I must be.
Of course. You're a hero, not a saint.
I know where your loyalties lie. Let us make a clean cut of things, for all our sakes.
Auntie, don't do this. You have
I'll
been
have
through a
no
terrible
more
thing.
Of this.
Everything I am because of you. Without you, who would I be? I never thanked you, not properly, for everything you've done. You have led me and taught me and laid me up into the world. You gave me my life, surely as my own mother. And I will thank you for that, from the bottom of my heart, to the day that I die. Mrs. Hawking, I'll be handing in my notice.
Mary, no!
Very well.
Don't do this!
You'll be paid through the end of the month. We'll see that you have an excellent character.
You can't be serious! Mary, please!
Nathaniel, please. It's done. God bless you. The both of you.
Well then, let's have it.
How could you?
It was already done, Nathaniel. She knew what she wanted. Clearly it wasn't this. I expect you'll be after me now to find a new maid.
Are you mad? How can you be the most brilliant person I know and yet be such a fool?
You know who I am. And if you don't like it, you can walk out that door with her. I've always preferred to be alone.
Yes. Yes, that's what you want. After 8 years, that's what this has all been coming to.
I swear to Christ, Nathaniel.
Go to bed. Or you burst your stitches and bleed out on the carpet.
How dare you?
No. Not another word. Not another breath. I've had quite enough for 8 years. Enough for a lifetime. Now you must go to bloody bed. I'll be here when you wake. I don't want you to be alone when you realize just what it is you've done.
Bloody lot of bother, these things.
It's worth the knowing, let me tell you. Learn that the hard way.
I hope you know how grateful we are. You pulling all this together for us.
Oh, well, think nothing of it. If you're going to get me in a Catholic church, you can be sure I'll see something's done right.
Just a few minutes to curtain. And how have we done here?
You'd think that cravat was a hangman's noose, but all's well that ends well.
Bearing up, then.
We've gone on raids with less of a cold walls.
Well, that's to be expected. Did you really propose over an arrest report?
Oh, go on.
For God's sake, man, have I taught you nothing?
Yeah, more than you might think. Your mother brought it down with her from Birmingham. Wanted to start things off right, seeing as so much is about to change.
I think it will do you good, you and Mary both. And you shall see America.
Heavens, I never thought we would. Do you think it's true they drown everything in cheese and tomato sauce there?
We can only hope not. But you shall take it by storm, I'm sure.
I know she's given up quite a lot.
She's done what she needed to do. You can be sure of that.
Which uncertain, though. New job, new country, new life. Not sure how we'll manage it.
Why, that's easy. Together.
Have you gone out there yet? Did you happen to see if she...
I did. And the answer is no, Nathaniel. I'm sorry. Can you believe the goal? Today of all days.
Darling, not today. Please?
Well, I'd like to say I outdid myself, but truly, I'm always this good. Good luck.
Well, my dear, look at you.
It was all Clara's doing. Thank heaven I'm rubbish at this sort of thing.
Oh, you shall be in good company then. Oh, but you needn't worry. He hasn't run off. I turned him out.
You've turned all this out, you and Clara. You really needn't have gone to such trouble.
Of course we did. All this, well, it's my send-off. Because you'll be missed more than any of us can say.
Nathaniel, I must ask. Did she come? Is she here?
No. No, she isn't. Mary, I'm so
Please.
Sorry.
It's all right. We said we wouldn't do this today.
It's only that you're leaving. Sailing off across an ocean. It just struck me all of a sudden. What will I do?
Oh, Nathaniel.
I'm afraid I'm done for. We've become quite a team, you and I, and now what? What of that strong right cross when the ruffians come behind me? Without you at my back, I'll have a trouncing within the week.
You handle yourself better than you think.
Then what about all the rest of it? Who's going to make those lovely little buns with the water I sing in? Who'll remember to have the wassail for the carolers at Christmas? And who'll I talk to after a mission? After all I've done? What will I do?
All right, every week and you'll write me back. You will tell me everything, won't you?
I'll drown you in foolscap. Even an ocean away, you won't be able to shut me up. I really am so happy for you and your grand adventure ahead. But you will miss me, won't you?
My dear Nathaniel, I'll miss you every moment. Everything we've done through over these past 8 years. The cases, the struggles, everything we've learned. If I travel the world and see all there is to see, nothing shall touch what we've done together.
There's nobody I'd rather have served with, Mary. Nobody.
Nor I. Blasted, I like you. I like the way you fuss over your suits and grumble at the cricket scars, and how you make fun of yourself, and how you never give up on anyone or anything, ever.
You don't fault me for it? Even when perhaps I should?
It's the best thing about you. You said you wouldn't cry.
I say a bloody lot of things. Oh, I do believe that's our cue. Just in time before I become truly un-English.
Shall I do all right then?
You always do. May I kiss the bride?
Once more into the breach.
Thank you. Was Mrs. Hawking, Part 6, Fallen Women. Polly Nichols, Annie Chapman, Elizabeth Stride, Catherine Eddowes, Mary Jane Kelly. Don't forget. Thank you, and have a good night.